Plagiarism. Rationale. First, the purpose of the present guidance is to inform applicants, HR officers, and hiring managers about the definition of plagiarism in the framework of a selection process in UNICEF, its consequences, and the procedures to be followed in cases of suspected plagiarism. Second, Article 101, paragraph 3 of the Charter of the United Nations states that the paramount consideration in the employment of the staff and in the determination of the conditions of service shall be the necessity of rescuing the highest standards of efficiency, competence, and integrity. Plagiarism is incompatible with the standard of conduct expected from international civil servants and, in consequence, appropriate actions will be taken to address established cases of plagiarism. Third, UNICEF may use automated tools to check the authenticity of a text submitted by a candidate as part of a selection process. What is plagiarism? Fourth, plagiarism consists of taking someone else's or one's own published work, words, or ideas without adequately creating its source. Fifth, plagiarism occurs in a written assessment, e.g. exercise, test, presentation, etc., when a candidate, whether intentionally or inadvertently, uses a text or idea which is not his or her own original output and fails to properly quote and or acknowledge its source. This applies regardless of the nature of the source and whether it was provided to the candidate as part of the assessment process. Sixth, proper reference consists of placing quotation marks around someone else's exact words and or acknowledging the origin of a text or idea by identifying its source. Seventh, each of the following will be considered as plagiarism. A, copying word for word a text without adding quotation marks at the beginning and end of the reproduced text or without providing the source. B, borrowing an idea or information from any written source without properly identifying its origin. This includes rephrasing a text without acknowledging the source, whether it is or not with the intention of placing them as the candidate's own output. 8. It is the candidate's obligation to avoid plagiarism as defined in paragraphs 4 to 7 above. Examples. 9. The following examples are provided to help applicants understand how to properly quote and acknowledge external sources and to illustrate what it is considered to be plagiarism. Source. Digitalization allows students with disabilities to connect with friends and make decisions for themselves, provides access to education for children living in remote or marginalized areas, and in humanitarian settings, helps students on the move find a safe route and connect with their families. Greater online connectivity has opened new avenues for civil engagement, social inclusion, and other opportunities with the potential to break cycles of poverty and disadvantage. The state of the world's children in a digital world, UNICEF report, Kilibi et al. 2017 at page 13. Literal quotation, acceptable quotation. Developments in digital technology offer new opportunities to design new products and services, but as stated in UNICEF's report, the state of the world's children in a digital world, it also allows children with disabilities to connect with friends and make decisions for themselves, and has opened new avenues for social inclusion and other opportunities with the potential to break cycles of poverty and disadvantage. Explanation. The candidate has identified the source and has placed the copy text between quotation marks. Plagiarism. Developments in digital technology offer new opportunities to design new products and services, but it also allows children with disabilities to connect with friends and make decisions for themselves, and has opened new avenues for social inclusion and other opportunities with the potential to break cycles of poverty and disadvantage. Explanation. The candidate has not identified the source where the information was taken from, nor has he or she placed the verbatim reproduced text between quotation marks. Paraphrase. Acceptable paraphrase. As stated in UNICEF's report on the state of the world's children in the digital world, digital technology can be a game changer for disabled children, offering them opportunities to socialize and to acquire greater personal autonomy, and can also break the cycles of disadvantage. Explanation. The source of the paraphrase text is sufficiently identified, and the candidate has not misleadingly led to believe that the idea is his or her own. Plagiarism. Digital technology can be a game changer for disabled children, offering them opportunities to socialize and to acquire a greater personal autonomy, and also can also break the cycles of disadvantage. Explanation. The source of the paraphrased text is not identified. The candidate thus misleadingly presented the content as being his or her own digital original input, while the anti-plagiarism software will only identify certain words as coinciding with the original source. Reading both texts becomes obvious that the candidate has plagiarized the former. Information on plagiarism provided to candidates. 10th, candidates who are subject to any assessment as part of the selection process shall be informed of UNICEF's interpretation of plagiarism and what the consequences of committing plagiarism are. Hiring managers may use the simple instructions for assessment in the annex or to this guidance note, or provide candidates with this guidance note at the time they are invited to the assessment as appropriate. Assessment of suspected cases of plagiarism. 11th, suspected cases of plagiarism will be assessed as a case-by-case basis. 12th, the percentage of coincidences identified by the anti plagiarism software between candidates' exercise or text and external documents or sources is a fallible indicator that the candidate might have incurred in plagiarism, but it is not always in itself conclusive. 13th, the criteria to determine if the candidate has incurred in plagiarism are exclusively whether non-original texts or ideas have been properly quoted and their source acknowledged or not. Sanctions. 14. In determining the appropriate measure to be taken in instances of plagiarism, each case will be assessed on its own merits, taking into account its particular facts and context, including aggravating and mitigating circumstances. 15th, consistent with the UN Charter's requirement to secure the highest standard of integrity as the paramount consideration in the employment of the staff, candidates who commit plagiarism will be excluded from the selection process. They shall be promptly informed of the decision and provided with any evidence available. 16th, in addition, depending on the specifics of the plagiarism committed, the following shall apply. A. External candidates may be excluded from being considered to future employment opportunities with UNICEF, and B. Internal candidates may be subject to discipline and other appropriate administrative measures. Process. 17th, when plagiarism is established by the hiring manager or local HR officer, regardless of whether or not the candidate is a staff member, the hiring office will A. exclude the candidate from the selection process and inform him or her of the decision. The available supporting evidence shall be provided to the candidate, and B. transmit the matter to the CF Policy and Administrative Law in DHR, who will recommend to the Director, Division of Human Resources, whether the case warrants additional action in accordance with paragraph 16 above. Thank you, my brothers and sisters. I think we will enjoy another text to read, and this is the kind of develop your own pronunciation and to get your English become better and better and better, and in due time you will get the best English you ever learned in your life. Thank you. God bless you.